My friends, prepare yourself for...
Shake your feet! Smell messy! Give me some handkerchief to eat! Ruffles in your underwear! Shake your feet!
What's going on out here? What's everybody so afraid of? We've got a great show tonight. We've got Bob Geldof from Live 8. What? We've got... What else do we have? We have a woman that can do amazing things with her tongue.
I don't want anybody getting confused and thinking that was me in the beginning of the show.
I was going to say, who was that great actor?
Yeah, that was Dan, our producer. He said he didn't know if that would be funny. I thought it was funny. I got a laugh out of it.
Oh,
Alfred
boy.
E. Viking, ladies and gentlemen, for your pleasure at home. By the way, you might notice we're dressed a little differently tonight. My posse. All right, what do you think? How do I look? Stand up. Let anyone see your costumes.
I didn't know you had such hairy legs.
Yeah. That's not my leg. Anyway, purpose is to tell you that this is our Halloween. This is sort of like our Halloween show, and it's not even a Halloween show, is it?
What is it?
What it is that we kind of have a wacky bit on Halloween, which is this
Wednesday. Yes.
Unless you're watching this in California or Philadelphia.
It was last week.
Then it's three Wednesdays ago. But this coming Wednesday, we're going to go out for Halloween.
Yeah.
And we're going to go trick-or-treating, and maybe at your house. We're going to come to your house.
Even if they're in L.A.?
Even if they're in L.A., we might be there. We might be there. So you'll see what happens, and this is to remind you. I don't know, we just felt like dressing up in bras.
I think so.
This bra really itches, I gotta tell you.
You know, I have that problem, too.
Hey, listen, what about this woman going around? What's her name?
Well, the big story this week, Shantae Fernandez.
I think it's Shanty Fernandez.
Could be.
But first of all, this Shantae Fernandez is the woman who locked her daughter in the trunk. This is the woman. Here she is.
It's not like she suffocated or she was extremely hot or like it was extremely cold or anything. Being that she was parked up front and being that we have security that goes up and down the parking lot and the alarm that I have on my car, yes, I was worried, but...
People feel bad for her?
Yeah, they're giving her a lot of help. People were calling her, offering donations.
This is a woman who should be locked in jail. She should be under psychiatric evaluation 24 hours a day, or they should just hang her. Who the hell locks a kid in a trunk?
Well, she thought it was safer than her house.
Yeah, well, it has an alarm system. I don't know, everyone in New York... I don't know what goes on in the rest
it's
of the country.
It's not like the kid suffocated.
Oh, but everyone in New York was raising money for this woman this week. Well, anyway, I want you to watch this. We have a new commercial for Shantae. She's going to be in a new business.
Yeah?
This is a business we'd like to see for Shantae. Watch this.
You're a single mother. You can't afford a babysitter. You've got no money for those fancy daycare centers. But you need to get to your $23,000 a year job. So what can you do?
Yeah, what can I do?
Protect your child now at the Shantae Fernandez Daycare Center.
Didn't I just say I can't afford a daycare center?
Relax. At the Shantae Fernandez Daycare Center, you don't need a dime. All you need is a flashlight, a stale donut, a coloring book, and the trunk of your car.
Hey, isn't this cruel? Treating my child like a spare tire?
Isn't it more cruel to leave your child in the hands of a potentially psychotic neighbor? At the Shantae Fernandez Daycare Center, all you need is a car and a safe exhaust system.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, son. How was it today?
Good. I learned some important life lessons. The separate decorations are really helping me out with my feelings.
Call the Shantae Fernandez Daycare Center. Call 1-800-SPARE-TIRE. That's 1-800-SPARE-TIRE. There's one as near as your garage.
I did it, and you can too.
Very good, Shantae. Where your kid's best pal will become a license plate. Hey, listen, I thought this week we should lock Gary in the trunk of a car. And, yeah, what do you think, man? And we'll see, you see what it's like. And we'll talk to you from the trunk of the car throughout the show.
You know, I saw Fred put the music in, yeah. Right? And I kept looking, and I didn't, it says check on Gary in one of the segments, and then all of a sudden during that bit, it hit me.
Come on, try it, man. Let's go. Let's see how it's like. We'll get you right in the car real quick. Come on.
Let's do it.
Ow.
Now, where is this car?
I got the trunk. I got a car parked right here by the WWOR garage. So be good. Oh, yeah. You can go in there.
Yeah.
And we'll see what it's like to spend an hour in a trunk. And we'll see how Gary can handle it as an adult. See what happens. Now, as you can see, you got a pillow, which is more than Shantae gave her son. You got a blankie. Do we have the donut and a flashlight? Here it is. Here's all your stuff, Gary. Get in here. Here's the donut.
I got claustrophobia.
You got claustrophobia? Good. That's even funnier. Here, take the donut. Get in there. Good test. Now, Gary, if you can't handle it, bang on the thing three times, but you'll be able to handle it.
I'm serious.
Here, here's toy. You seriously have claustrophobia? Yeah. All right, get in. Don't worry. Good. Toys. These are toy soldiers. Give you something to do.
He's complaining. He didn't
yeah, but don't worry if you have claustrophobia because you got a flashlight. And it's on.
A coloring book. I need a coloring book. Wait. Okay. All right.
You okay, son?
I'm all right.
We'll be back. We'll check on Gary. Out!
Flipping out! Come on,
flipping
man!
Flipping out!
Come on!
Hey, Shanti, you really don't have the key?
We don't have the key!
We don't have the key, Gary!
Come on, man!
What?
I got it at the front desk!
Come on!
I'll go get the key, okay?
Dan, put it somewhere.
Howard, please. What?
We'll be back.
You broke the key.
Oh, no. I broke the key.
Oh,
I broke the key.
Whose car is this?
Come on, man.
All right, we're coming right back.
Come on.
What?
Come on.
Hold on, we'll be right back.
All
Give
right,
me
come
a
on.
Key.
Can you breathe in there?
Upside down.
Come on, really.
This is an awful position.
This is totally not cool.
Totally
come on,
not cool.
No, don't.
This is totally not cool.
I mean, I'll come in and stay in for like a couple of seconds at a time, but I can't stay. I mean,
we can do that.
You know, I can't stay in here. Yeah, seriously, with the trunk closed, I'll flip. There. I will flip.
We can just open it up.
It's fine.
He's fine.
You're fine.
Yeah.
You're fine.
Wait. Oh, no.
We got an IFP. We got something for you to hear.
You can hear the whole show.
You can talk to us.
He doesn't want to miss the show.
No, I don't I don't care about missing the show, man.
Just
give me something to hear.
Yeah.
Give him a coloring book. Yeah.
You got a coloring book. You got a coloring book.
Hold on a second.
It's
sitting right here.
There. If a five-year-old can take it,
hey, yeah, you big baby.
Was in a
Stick that in. Stop saying that. I'm taking this. John's eating the donuts. Get it over here, man. You stay in here. We'll be fine. We'll be working at Fortune Ops. All right.
We'll be back.
Here, somebody hold the key. Yeah, hold the key. Thanks. We'll go talk to Bob Geldof, and we'll check on Gary. What a baby he is. If a five-year-old could handle it, why can't he? Yeah, he can't take it.
I can't take it, boss. I can't take it.
I'm not kidding.
I'm not kidding. I can't take it.
Well, he could take it, believe me. What a big baby. All right. His best pal is a license plate.
Just think he got into that getup to get into a trunk.
Yeah, right. Anyway, are we going to bring up Bob Geldof? I don't know, are we? We are? Okay, bring up
Look,
Bob.
There he is.
It is Bob. Bob! Bob! Hey, this is the guy who saved everybody. Bob's got a new album. Bob Geldof. How you doing, Bob?
Good to see you.
It's Bob Geldof, everybody.
Where's your costume, Bob?
Bob, this is to remind people that Halloween is next week, and we will be coming to their house to trick-or-treat.
Very nice. I've never seen a head with a hard-on before.
Do they do that in Ireland?
I said I've never seen a head with a hard-on before.
So we're going to be dirty today, huh? In other words, you don't care if I lose this show. Is that what you're saying?
Mr. Well, Save the Earth is going to relieve us of our jobs.
Bob feels bad for little black children in Ethiopia.
Yes.
But a big, ugly white guy in America...
like yourself.
...has got to come on and use expressions like erection, hard-on, these kinds of expressions, and he is going to make me lose my show.
Yes.
Well, Bob, you lost the last one. You know, I thought you may as well keep up the sort of percentages, yeah.
First of all, let me introduce Bob properly, because I didn't do it. Bob is a great musician. Everybody knows
yes.
that. But that's not, you know, that's only one aspect of Bob. Bob saved the whole world.
Without a Viking hat.
Without a Viking hat. He did it from his bedroom.
That's it.
Come on, Bob, take some credit.
All right.
You were knighted, for Christ's sake.
It's Sir Bob, isn't it?
This is Sir Bob.
Thank you, Rob. I'm
telling you.
Listen,
you
know, I didn't know about this trunk thing. I just saw that, and this woman got off.
Yeah, do you believe that? And people are raising money for the woman who locked her kid in the trunk. Do you believe that?
Why did she get off? What was the...
Because everybody felt sorry for her.
What about the child?
Yeah, why would you feel sorry for a woman who locked her kid in the trunk?
She's only five.
It's unbelievable.
Isn't she a danger to the child?
Yeah, I think so, Bob. But, you know...
Do you think you'll get off for locking Gary up?
The only way Bob abuses his children is by giving them crazy names.
Yeah,
Fifi,
I think so.
Peaches. What'd you name the third one?
Pixie!
This man should be locked up as well, as far as I'm concerned.
In a trunk.
That's a form of child abuse. But, you know, as we sit here and we say Halloween is going to be next Wednesday,
yes.
I think about in Ethiopia, Halloween would be Thanksgiving. It really would, wouldn't it, Bob?
Well, not if you have to wear one of those things, don't really.
Well, I mean, it's worth it to get a little food. But seriously, Bob raised so much money for the people of Ethiopia, I've invited an Ethiopian gentleman to come here and thank Bob.
So thank you.
Because nobody does it. And then we'll talk about his album, the Vegetarian Album.
All right.
Vegetarians of Love.
Vegetarians of Love. I call it the Vegetarian Album.
You know, there's the White Album, there's the Vegetarian Album.
And there's
album.
The Vegetarian Album. But anyway, we've invited... I think you're going to like this. You helped the people of Ethiopia. I don't know if they ever thanked you properly. Did they?
What is this, Howard? What's coming?
It feels a little skeptical to me.
All right, this gentleman, this is Chief... This is King...
King.
Janitor. From the Yulus tribe.
The Yulus tribe.
That's right, King Janitor of the Yulus tribe.
Where is
he? Who's here to bring a gift to Bob Geldof to sing his spiritual dance. King Janitor, please. There he is, King Janitor. Janitor, take a seat, please.
Is this what happens when you get locked in a trunk?
This is what happens. Now take a seat, King Janitor. Please.
I think he's still hungry. He's got one of those bellies like those little kids.
Yeah, you know, your belly is rather distended, isn't it? Did you get any of the food that Bob, Bob raised a lot of money. Did you ever get any of the food?
Much food.
You got...
Yes.
Do me a favor. Get close to your microphone, King Janitor.
Much food.
You got much
is
food.
Is that his bowl he's carrying?
You know, I understand. Now, you have... Now, you have the traditional plates in the lips. Is that what most Ethiopians wear? Yes. Yes, it is. King Janitor, I know that you brought a gift for Bob Geldof. What do you want to say to him to thank the people?
And that's tribal paper, I see.
Yes,
you
tribal paper. What do you want to say to Bob?
I appreciate much food. There's much good.
Ted, can you speak in your regular voice? Just speak in your regular voice. You don't have to put on a voice. You appreciate
it. Why is he dressed as a Fijian as well? Viking Fijian, I guess.
Who knows who you helped? But anyway, what is this present you brought, Bob? Let's see.
Very good present.
What is it?
Is this your normal voice, Ted? Or this is the normal
voice? No, not my normal voice.
Now, what is this, King Janitor? What is
this? The baby tribe.
What is this?
That's my baby son I'm giving.
Is this a necklace?
Necklace for
boy, oh boy.
You mean that's your son? And yeah. You made a necklace out
made
of him?
Necklace.
Bob, would you wear that? This is a
it's
picture.
It's fantastic.
This is actually some of the children that you saved. We made the King Janitor brought a necklace that you could wear. And stand up and model that, Bob. Please, please, please. So, King Janitor.
King Janitor, I can't thank you. Is there a trunk?
Is there a trunk for that?
I can put that in a trunk.
This is so beautiful.
King Janitor, I'm deeply moved.
Isn't
know?
That nice? I'm deeply
moved. You're going to keep that in a very safe and a place of honor.
I want to thank King Janitor. We'll be back with Bob Geldof to tell us about his album. And we're going to come back and bang on the trunk with Gary and see
we'll
how he's doing.
We'll check Gary. Yeah.
We'll check Gary, all right?
We can give him this. You want this?
Yes, we're going to check on Gary right now with Bob Geldof. show is this?
I had to go away.
Check the trunk with Gary. Hold on 1 second.
Then it begins.
Gary's actually been in here the whole time? Has he? Are you freaking out in there?
No, I'm doing better.
It's better? What do you got? You got your flashlight on?
No, I turned it off. I was actually taking a nap.
Taking a nap?
I knew he was asleep.
I'm a big fan.
He's turned into John Oates.
You know, like that Chantay lady, Bob. Gary is, you know, I check on my son while I'm working.
Look at what he's been doing.
He's been playing with soldiers and stuff. It's always.
I have to be honest with you. It went from being freaky to being very boring.
Really?
It's boring in here.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. The poor kid is in the trunk and everything.
Did you not get into your isolation chamber thing?
Yeah, I feel like altered states.
Altered states. I just got an idea.
The altered states of America.
What if we raised money for all the children locked in trunks?
Yeah.
And we had a big concert.
Sorry?
We had a big concert. From the trunk, we had a big concert. No, wait a second, Gary. Why don't you get out of the trunk? Let's lock Bob in the trunk and let him do a song from his new album, Vegetarians of Love. Come on, Bob. Come on, in the spirit of this, man. The poor little Shantay. Bop, 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 bop. Go ahead. Gee, Bob. You sure you want to try this? Yeah, sure, Bob.
It's a real trunk.
This is where the kid was locked in.
Real trunk.
This kind of trunk.
No, this guy.
Go ahead. There's no tricks here.
No.
I'm going to lock you in here, Bob.
Oh,
careful.
Jesus.
Watch your head.
Ouch.
Remember, you're a father of three. Second. Bob Geldof, everyone.
I need this request, Bob, is it?
What song will you be doing? Do that song that you do so well.
Which one?
Please lock me away. What song are you going to be doing, Bob?
I don't like Mondays.
How about I don't like Mondays from the trunk?
I can't do that. It has to be.
What do you mean you don't like?
It has
what
to
do
be
you mean?
I hear you.
You know, here, wait. If I put the flash, you better leave your flashlight on too. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
From the trunk. I don't like Mondays. Try. I don't like Mondays.
Is the sound on this thing?
Yeah, this sound.
I'll try, but I can't see.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
I need to be able to see.
Hey, you know, a little 5-year-old managed to handle all of this.
And he did an entire album from
it. Now watch your head. Jackson Brown recorded his last album from a trunk.
Yeah, I don't want to ruin his childbearing possibilities. Be careful.
You all right there, Bob?
Here we go.
Be careful. You okay?
Yeah.
All right, here I go, Bob. I'm closing it. All right. Go ahead.
Is that it? Hold on.
He's already ready to come out.
Hey, how about I don't like Monday?
This is a song called The End of the World.
How about I don't like Monday? End of the World.
Though it strikes you as seeming a little absurd, I'm here to announce the end of the world. It'll happen sometime between now and high noon. It doesn't give you much time, but it's happening real soon. It'll start with a whimper, it'll end with a bang. It'll leave a big hole where we could have sang. Everybody sing it.
What Bob doesn't realize is when he's done with the song, he's locked in the trunk for the rest of the show.
For 5,000 years, you must surely have heard.
Can we hear Bob? Where's the song?
We said it was coming. Now just wait and see.
We're going to put gas on the show.
And there it is.
This is for all the children who are locked in trunks. So everyone outside, look over the sky. It's the last time you'll see.
Boy, he's really jamming, huh?
Yeah, he is doing a concert.
Well, let's keep the music up. Let's see what he realizes we're not there. I can do a Snapple commercial in the meantime, all right? Well, this isn't Snapple. Wait a second. Do you hear him?
No, keep it up. Keep it up. Don't turn
How
it down.
I can hear it.
The end
anyway,
years.
Say the truth, he has more friends in that trunk than he does in real life.
Oh.
We got a couple of Snapple bottles here that I want to show you. I just can't wait till he finishes and realizes we're not there.
And
I think this might be the end.
This might be it. There you go.
Live from the trunk.
You don't know how true. He's just gonna play another song.
Well, he's in there.
Hey, Bob, can you hear me?
I don't think he has any hookup to hear
you. He has no hookup?
No.
All right, good. Well, he's still going.
A guy who can occupy himself. That's what I like.
Gary's not a complainer like you. Anyway, Snapple's my favorite drink, and that's why I've asked them to be a sponsor on the TV show. They've been good enough to consent.
Why, would if you were locked in a trunk, this is what you'd want to take with
you. I really would. I'd say, Mom, don't give me donuts. Give me Snapple. Snapple Clear Iced Tea is so good. I'll tell you why. It's brewed 100% natural. What's this drink here?
Oh, Snappa.
That's the fruit punch. You know what this is? If you're going out and you're doing a workout or something, you drink this. It's 100% natural. A lot of sports drinks, I won't mention their name, but you see them on TV all the time advertised, sports drinks. They have tons of chemicals. Hey, what's Bob Geldof doing in there?
He's playing with himself?
Nothing wrong with that. Anyway, this is all natural, tastes great, and it replaces energy. That's what I'm saying. It replaces energy.
Ooh.
And these are all flavors that are made from the best stuff on earth. Take a look at this Grape Aid.
All natural. 100%
all natural. It's real good for your kids to drink, okay? So look for Snapple products wherever you go. Maybe we better release Bob from that trunk, huh?
It's, you know, he's the Sir Bob and a... You know, if this gets back to England, they could strip him of his title.
I'm thinking of getting out of this costume eventually, you know?
Why?
You like it like this?
Yeah, why not do the whole show that way?
Hey, by the way, coming up, we have Celestine, the woman with no arms and no legs. She's going to show us how she eats.
She's our big star tonight.
Yeah. Bob was okay. I'm thinking
but
of
we're really excited about Celestine.
I'm thinking of locking Celestine in a golf bag. I don't know. We'll see what happens, all right? Boy, see, Gary, you're a big baby. Bob Geldof was digging it in there.
Yeah, but you have to have a fear of that stuff to know what it's like.
All right. Well, there you go.
He explained it perfectly.
If it doesn't bother you, then how could you know what it's like to be locked in a trunk?
Well, that's very true.
Even if you're locked in it, if it doesn't bother you, how could you know?
How did you know it bothered you? Because you were never locked in a trunk.
I was locked in a locker once in junior high school.
How did that happen?
After football practice, we were goofing around.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's hijinks, exactly. They locked me in a locker bro, and I totally flipped out.
Yeah.
So, in other words, you've always had friends like us.
Your whole life has been like this.
Oh, man.
It's just an old trick. Telling somebody they can't fit in a locker, and they get in, and you lock them, and then you walk away.
Yeah, but now I'm getting paid for it, boy.
Progress.
Well, Robin, you want to take a look at the news, or what?
Yes, Howard. Well, the big story, of course, was the woman who locked her baby in a trunk, and we already talked about that. We have Bob Geldof out in the back seeing what it's like.
Sir Bob Geldof. We've got an actual knight in a trunk, Robin. Boy, what a show this is. No wonder it's so easy getting guests. No wonder Joan Rivers keeps canceling on us.
Yeah, I guess she's going to cancel for next week, too.
Yeah, right. She's supposed to be here next week for the trick-or-treat show.
Just wait till she hears about this.
By the way, are we going to contact Edgar during that show?
That's what you said.
I want to do it. I think Joan's up for it. We're bringing in a professional medium next week to contact Edgar.
Have you told anybody about this?
No.
Oh.
I'm just assuming we can do it. Joan seems to have a good sense of humor.
I meant people with the show so they could get us a medium.
Yeah, I got that all set up.
Is that right?
Yeah, don't we?
We're working on it.
Yeah, we got a medium coming. We're working on it.
We got her in a trunk. Wait a minute! How'd you get out of the trunk?
Hey, what are you doing back here? How did you get out? It's Houdini. You want to do some news with us?
Yeah.
All right, Bob will do some news with us.
Well, Bob, you want to hear about this.
Yeah, you can't get rid of Bob, you know?
The star who wouldn't leave.
This is the only show that, like, the guests won't leave.
Yeah, we always lose control somehow.
We always say goodnight, and then they just come right back on. They don't care.
Well, we witnessed a miracle here in New York this week, Howard.
Yeah.
You heard about it. A picture of a saint in the Greek Orthodox religion, Saint Irene, started crying.
Did you hear about this?
Week.
We are like voodoo people. You understand? It's a good thing I'm in this costume.
Check out the Irish churches.
Yeah?
All the statues nod.
They do?
Yeah, no, there was a big outbreak of nodding statues in Ireland about 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Because they have statues on the side of the road there, like it's Catholic country shrines.
Excuse me.
Well, you know where
Excuse
Ireland
me.
Is, do you?
I don't want to hear about your voodoo. I don't, in fact, I don't want to hear about your voodoo there, Bob. Listen to me.
The nodding statues.
Here's the crying statue.
Our Lady of the Nodding Statues. You never heard of
it? Listen to this.
This is Saint Irene.
During my show, my crew nods out.
Here she goes. Look at that. Real tears.
Let me see that.
Look at that.
Excuse me. Let me explain something here.
Hey, look, in the back, the priest is going to show you there. Nothing's in the back to make her cry.
Wait, let me show you something. Let me show you something here. Let me see this. Wait a second. I
didn't
get a good shot of this. Oh.
See, there are the tears. And this guy's going to explain.
It's
condensation.
Because we think the icon, Klein.
Hey, Bob, maybe you ought to go to that look. I
You've
like
already
it.
Gone for it.
Because you got the hair.
Beard. He looks like you. Look at the glasses.
You think he looks like me?
If he put horns in his head, it'd be you. You
think? Wait a second. You're saying, you're saying that looks like me? You mean if we put...
Robin, you're wearing these jewels. I'm not used to seeing you.
I dressed up for you, Bob.
You mean like that?
There's Howard. Correct.
And a bra?
There he is.
Because the leaders want to start a war. So the Saint Eritus of Orlando, it's a pattern.
Listen to me. I want to say something.
He's speaking English, by the way.
He's speaking English? Well, I'm going to speak some English right now. I'll take a cheeseburger and several fries. There's no way that statue's crying.
You tell me what it is, only from her eyes. She is a mess. Somebody ought to slap her and tell her to get herself together.
It's condensation, right? It's in a... Do you believe any of that stuff?
That's yes, I do. I do believe it.
You believe that statue's crying?
Yeah.
Lock him back in the trunk.
You're there.
Bob, you see this thing here?
Yeah.
In Ethiopia, they eat these, believe it or not, because there's nothing to eat over there. But thanks to you, there's some food now.
The problem is they make them there.
They make these in Ethiopia.
And they don't realize they can't eat them.
Right, there it is. See, Bob always hones in on the problem. This is the Brother P-Touch 3. I talk about it on the radio. I talk about it on television till I'm blue in the face. This is a great thing. It makes labels. Today I'm using a black background and a gold lettering
system. That's a very nice motif.
Isn't that nice? These are so good. The Brother P-Touch 3. Let me just say that you can label anything with this. You can label anything on your desk, in your kitchen, your holiday gifts. You can give this as a holiday gift. It looks like a little computer, doesn't it? And that's exactly what it is. You hit a print button, everything prints out. You can use different sizes, different styles, different fonts. Fonts means, print types.
I see.
You understand that, okay?
Jaunty music.
And let me just say that I use one of these at home. You like to label? All right. I have a special tonight.
What's that?
Instead of running out to the store to buy one of these, which is a big pain in the neck,
yeah.
I need you to call a 1-800 number right now. All right? This is just for Howard Stern viewers. Could you put those cue cards lower? It looks like I'm looking into the sky. Thank you. What is this? Nobody wants to get down and kneel before me. Okay. Let me give the 1-800 number right now, all right? You call this special number, and what happens is you can buy the Brother P-Touch 3. It's 1-800-526-6666. Ask for your own P-Touch at a special low price.
Ooh, that's nice.
They're putting us on notice this week. The Brother people said, hey, we'll give out the 1-800 number. We'll see how many of these you sell.
Uh-oh.
If you sell them well, we'll keep coming back and advertise.
It's a test, folks.
It's really a great piece of equipment. And if you don't like it, you have 30 days to give it back. So do it now. Just call the 1-800 number. We're back with Bob Geldof. We're doing the news, and we're just taking a look at that crying statue there, for God's sake. Bob Geldof believes that that's a crying statue. That's a picture locked in glass. You understand, Robin?
So how'd the tears get there?
Although, we have our own miracle on this show. I took the press photo of Dan Foreman, our producer.
Mm-hmm.
And if you notice, ever so slightly in the corners of his eyes, he's what? Been crying lately. Did you get that? Did you see it? It's a miracle. Watch again. Did you see it? You see? Look. Wait, look. Watch again and see. Watch.
One more time.
The miracle's over?
That's it? No more miracles.
The miracle just went
here.
All over all
the on the Stern Show. Well.
The miracle's going to buy new monitors.
Yeah, the miracle is we have no money for new monitors. Anyway, so Bob's here, and we're talking about the news. What else is going on?
Well, let's see if this works.
All right.
It was a big week in sports, Howard. Yeah. You know, we had the big fight.
Big fight?
Yes, Evander Holyfield and Buster Douglas. That happened last night. I'm just seeing if you have the tape.
I got it.
Of course not. There's a miracle. Take that out. You got the wrong tape.
This is some professional show, huh? It's really a mess. Hey, you think this show would go over in England? England, this show would go over. You know why? Because there's only 4 shows on in the whole country. It is true, right? This show would be a big hit.
Yep. So anyway, here's Buster Douglas. You know, he lost in 3 rounds. Here's what he had to say about his big loss.
All right, here's what he had to say. Let's see what he had to say.
Well, I began. I said, like this. That people say, he's got.
Oh, there he is.
You know,
he don't look too good, does he?
Hey, was it a fight?
Well, I don't bet people lie on it.
See there?
There it is.
Okay, so I don't have Buster Douglas. Yeah. But he lost anyway. What I do have.
Well, that could have been Buster Douglas.
you sound like that.
Big fatso. He's had his big shot. He doesn't even lose weight for it.
Got 24 million, though.
Yeah, he got 24 million, Bob.
I thought it was Buster Douglas that came in here like King Janitor.
That was King Janitor.
Same lip, right?
Yes. I tell you that.
So anyway, what we do have is some of the speeches given by the Cincinnati Reds, big World Series champs. We have speaking to us now a guy named Chris Sabo and another guy named Rob Dibble.
I'd like to thank everybody because you guys are pretty good. And I just like to say that no one gave us a chance. We kicked their ass in four straight. And that's all I got to say. And all I think... We come from our show.
Nice Nazi haircut.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hey, we did it. We kicked their ass. Great. Guy with a Nazi haircut. Hey, he makes me nervous.
It was a ball game.
Thanks, Jethro. Hey, we did it. We kicked their ass. Everybody with the kick in the ass. So, Bob, why isn't there peace in the world?
What is this, Cincinnati Reds? What is it?
Cincinnati Reds baseball team. Come on, Bob. You know this stuff. You're not that avid.
Like TV, they don't have baseball in the gym.
It's either that or snooker.
They're out there improving on the field. They can talk all they want, but they're gonna sit home all winter, and they know they don't got nothing because we got the ring, and we got the money, and we got everything. Thank you.
You got the ring, and we got the money.
You people believed in us when nobody else in America did. We went out there. We kicked their ass.
Yeah. Yeah.
You think they've really done something?
Yeah, you think they'd like raise money for Ethiopians or something the way, you know? Really, see,
Geldof. You never carry on
Geldof
like that.
Geldof should have been in front of the Queen. I kicked their ass! Look at it, I raised millions! Hey, how much money did you ever raise anyway?
If I'd played baseball,
yeah,
I wouldn't have, you know, got into this whole thing, you know, and you wouldn't be here talking about it. Did you ever think about that?
He's so deep, I swear
I tell
to God.
You, I never thought of that.
I'm telling you. I'm telling you, Bob.
You get off this joke. All I've been right, hearing this joke from you for 4 years.
Bob's like,
you
real
know?
Sick of Ethiopia jokes and stuff. You know what I mean?
Jesus.
Jesus, Bob. That picture of Dan was crying. That miracle occurred, and now I'm soaking wet.
That's only because I'm here.
I know.
That miracle would not have worked.
So no more Ethiopian stuff. This is the last time we talk to Bob about raising money for Ethiopia.
Is that it? We can't ever mention it again?
And I want to thank Bob.
Please, Robin, can you not come up with a good new joke, you know?
Let me tell you about Nutrisystem, okay?
Yeah. That's a nice segue, isn't it, you know?
Speaking of feeding Ethiopian. In all
seriousness. This is what you should have tried.
Yeah, this is so good. You should have sent this to
Ethiopia.
Well,
they're all craving control snacks, you know?
Yes, I do. You know,
they're really into it.
Well, let me tell you something, Bob. This is a great sponsor of ours. So many people try to lose weight, and they can't. But now I have a Howard Stern special. I think I've convinced a lot of people to go on the Nutrisystem weight loss program. Haven't I?
I think so.
I think a lot of people say, but wait a second, maybe it's too expensive. Although I don't think it's too expensive because you go to the supermarket every week and you go shopping.
When you think of it, you've probably fed as many people as Bob Geldof.
You know?
Does that say microwave popcorn?
No, popcorn, Bob.
It's a glass.
Popcorn.
Look at this.
Yeah, put your Bob.
You're deaf and blind,
yeah,
Bob.
Yeah, I think so. Anyway, this is the second best way to lose weight. You know what the first way is, don't you, Bob?
What's that?
Move to Ethiopia.
Oh.
All right. Now, here's
the
thing.
There's a special we're running.
Yeah, let's just ridicule everything Bob's done in his life, okay? Yeah, let's just do that,
destroyed
all right?
The music.
Destroyed his music from the trunk and everything else. Now, if you call now through Monday, you can pay for a 15-pound program and lose the rest for free. That's the deal if you get in on Nutrisystem now. So now, pay for a 15-pound program. This is not why I got a television show, by the way. I'm sitting here
I thought it was
this.
The way of these costumes.
Yeah, I think I'm getting out of this costume. You know what I mean?
But don't you get fat again afterwards?
No, you don't.
No,
that's
I
the amazing
did it.
Thing. Robin's on it, and she lost all her weight and stayed thin. All right? So the heavier you are right now, the more you save. Because all you pay for is a 15-pound program on Nutrisystem. Would you call now? They're great-tasting, low-calorie entrees like chicken lasagna, even pizza, snacks, too, everything. They got it all. Even my own family, my sister lost 19 pounds on Nutrisystem. Call 1-800-321-THIN. 1-800-321-THIN. All right. Hey, welcome back to the show that never ends.
Welcome back, my friends.
Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. I'm dressed in this costume because, well, I enjoy wearing a bra, number one. And number two, no, seriously, because this week we're going to go trick-or-treating and we might be coming to your house. And when we get there and stuff, you can have us in.
I'd like to see this happen.
Yeah, oh, it's going to happen. It's going to. Well, at least I have the intentions of going out trick-or-treating. But I know by Wednesday, when Wednesday rolls around, I'm not going to want to trick-or-treat
You're
anymore.
You're going to think that's a big pain in the butt. Yeah. Why did I think of it?
You know, we probably won't show up at your house, come to think of it. Well, anyway. Hey, listen, the reason we're sitting here, We got a call on the radio show this week from Celestine. She's the lady with no arms and no legs. And she wants to come in and show off how she can eat stuff without
anybody
helping.
Well, she called us actually to tell us she was engaged.
Yeah, this is amazing to me. I know so many women out there who are so frustrated because they can't get a date. They're putting ads in New York Magazine, Newsday, the Daily News and the Post, Robin as well, chocolate singles, whatever. They're putting ads in the magazines and the papers, and nobody can get a date. Here's a woman with no arms or no legs, honest to God, with no arms or no legs.
This will be her second marriage.
This is her second marriage. She's already been through one husband. Here she is, Celestine, everybody.
There she is.
There she is. And her new husband. Well, her fiancé.
Fiancé, her intended.
Yeah, right over here, so Celestine can have a place at the table.
How you doing?
God bless you, Celestine. I can't believe it. Here you are.
Good to see you.
Good to see you, too. Now, this is, of course, your name is Roy?
That's right.
Roy, put on that microphone so we can talk to you, please. You are in love with Celestine?
Yes, I am.
Is it because she can do so many things that she's handicapped, right? But she doesn't really act handicapped, right? She can do everything.
No. Oh, no, she can do everything that anybody else could do with their normal arms and legs.
Look at this guy. This is not a bad-looking man. This is a nice-looking man, Celestine.
Ooh, look at her. She's got that little grin.
You got that look of love, sweetheart. I've never seen you like this. You are a changed woman. You used to be very bitter and angry when I talked to you.
Yeah, I was, but I'm happy now.
You're happy now?
Yeah.
And you two have had relations already, or are you saving that for the wedding night?
Oh, no.
Well, wait a second. You have had relations already?
We live together.
Yes. You do live together?
Mm-hmm.
My God almighty, that is so wonderful. I can't believe it.
I'm amazed.
I am actually amazed. I'm more amazed I don't get up and punch Monty for talking during the segment, so I can't even hear what you're saying, to be honest. This show, people walk around talking the whole time. People are passing out. They can't believe Celestine got him in. I'll be honest with you. I didn't think you'd ever get married again.
Why?
Because I just didn't think guys would go for you.
We didn't even know you were dating.
I wasn't.
You weren't?
Really?
I just met him about 8 or 9 months ago.
That's right. And it was true love right away? I mean, you met her and that was it?
That was it.
And you moved
love
right
at
in?
First sight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well... Yeah, I moved right in and,
You've had other women, of course, right?
Oh,
this is not your first woman. You're a man of the world?
No.
This is your first marriage?
Oh, no, she's the first real woman I had.
Really?
Because I had other women that
Do you like her because sexually you could just do anything with her and she can't, she can get into any position and everything, right? And she's incapable of putting up a fight, for God's sakes. I mean, you can pretty much do what you want.
No, it's not that. She's a beautiful person, you know what I mean? She's very understandable. She's sweet, and I don't take her handicap to be anything other than what she really is, and she's
the person inside.
Yeah.
You were showing off on the radio. You said you could eat anything. You could actually take a spoon and a fork and eat anything.
Mm-hmm. So you never said you two go out to dinner and all that.
Mm-hmm.
You do? And I said you come on the show and prove it to me?
He proposed to me in a restaurant.
He did propose. Let me recreate that. What were you guys eating? I got every food here imagined. Let's recreate the proposal. Everybody wants to see that.
We had shrimp?
We don't have that.
How about soup?
Soup is just close.
All right, soup. Now, wait a second. Now, how do I do this, Celestine? You mean you can do this without any help?
Yeah.
Let me see this. This is amazing to me. Let me give you a little. I don't see how you can do it. I see he's helping you.
Mm-hmm.
All right, go ahead.
Oh,
boy. See, I don't see how you can get the spoon into your mouth after you take a scoop. That soup's been laying out in the cold
that's
for a while, I think.
It's solid.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, we made it too easy. The soup's solid. You're an amazing woman. You know, I think I'm going to... Oh, yes! Yes! No wonder you fell in love, for crying out loud. Fabulous. So she eats the soup, and you go, I got to have this woman. And she got a mouth that won't quit, right? And then what'd you do? You got on your hands and knees, and you just said, Celestine?
Gave all everything I have.
Really? Unbelievable. That is amazing. But that's soft food. There's no way you could eat a steak.
Sure.
You could eat a steak?
I'm shocked.
Do we have to cut it for you?
Do we have to cut it?
You can.
Oh, that's cheating. Forget about it.
No way.
You could cut
a steak? You see, there's a lot of girls at home who are watching this, can't get a husband, can't cut a steak. Celestine does it all.
I cook too.
You do cook?
Yeah.
It's amazing. Here's a steak. Can't believe it. My wife, I have to cut a meat for her. And she can use her hands and legs.
Good arms and legs.
There you go. All right, now what do I have to do? Oh, your husband will help you here.
Well, she doesn't want your help.
Yeah, all of a sudden I'm not good enough for you, huh? Oh, see, he does get to cut it.
Well, there's no way you could cut that yourself. Oh, there's just no way.
She's gonna cut it.
She is gonna cut it. Holy cow. Hey, Gary, you can't even cut your own meat. You know she did a brain operation on someone last week? Brain surgery? I'm not kidding. Amazing. Amazing. Yes!
There it
Wait.
Is.
She must be a hell of a lady in bed. You can do it all, can't you?
Look at that. She tells us about this stuff and we never believe her.
Wow. I never believed you could do it. You are my hero, I swear to God. Hey, are we going to take a break? Anyway, congratulations to Celestine and Roy. This is truly amazing.
When's the big day?
We're going to have it at the Coliseum.
Don't talk with your mouth full, Celestine, for God's sake.
So yeah.
I would like to invite everybody, your fans and everybody along.
You want to get married at the Coliseum?
What Coliseum?
The one we did the video.
The Nassau Coliseum, 20,000 seats?
What, are you selling tickets to your wedding, Celestine?
Is that it?
That's how we got to get a home.
Oh, get a home. Mm-hmm. Roy better get a job. Never mind.
He has a job.
Now, Roy, what do you do?
Oh, I work for a private contractor. We work into the casinos. You know what I mean? I do landscaping.
Landscaping and stuff like that? Well, you're a lucky woman. All I know is this guy's a good-looking guy. I don't understand why you women can't get dates.
Yeah.
That's all it is. Celestine, you just know how to attract him, don't you?
Yes, I do.
God bless you. All right.
You little vixen.
You little temptress. We'll be back right after these words.
If you want to see more of Celestine, you can get her tape by writing to Celestine Tate, Post Office Box 7962, Atlantic City, New Jersey, 08404.
We're having some trouble with some of our spokesmodels from week to week, so we decided what we're going to do is ask you to write in if you would like to be a spokesmodel on this show.
Was that spontaneous? You just thought that up?
Yes. So now we got a couple of letters. I'm going to let you vote now on four contestants.
Oh.
All right. First of all, these are just regular toll calls. They don't cost you anything. This is you see that number on the screen there? That number will allow you to vote. We won't make a profit off of this stuff. All right. This is not like a show. This is not like what is it? Joan Rivers has a 900
yes.
number.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if she does or not, but anyway.
Or Entertainment Tonight. I know they have a 900 number.
That's who has the 900 number. Entertainment Tonight. They have you voting on whether you think Paul Newman should stay married to Joanne Woodward. You know, that kind of stuff.
For
well,
cash.
Anyway, tonight you can vote for one of four women to be our next spokesmodel. Just call 201-480-VOTE and then pick a number, okay?
Hmm.
All right. Now, the first person is Missy. She says here in her letter, I would really like to be a spokesmodel. It would be such a thrill. I always wanted to be a model on TV. That's her picture.
That's her, okay.
That's her. All right, if you like her, dial number one. Second is Sherry. Dial number two if you like her. And number three is Tracy. Dial number three if you want her to see her on the show. We'll get her in a little bit better outfit than that. And I wonder if she can eat a steak with a knife and a fork. Now, number four is Donna. Dial number four. And if you're gay and you're not interested in any of these women, dial number five. All right? So, again, the number is 201-480-VOTE, and you will see these women as spokesmodels, all right? And then we'll have the final vote and hopefully the winner next week, and we'll have her down here, all right? Anyway, here's another thing we're doing on the show. We're having a house party.
Busy.
Yeah, we're busy little beavers. Well, we never thought we'd get picked up past 13 weeks. I swear to God, they got to cancel this show. I hate doing it. I hate being on television. I think it stinks on ice. Poor Celestine's my only guest, Bob Geldof.
She wants to come back every week, though.
Yeah, she's in here pitching me during the commercials. What is it? What do you want to do? You want to come back every week?
I want people to dream up what they think I can't do with my mouth, and I'm going to do it right
Believe
now.
Me, sweetheart, you could do just about anything with your mouth. Maybe my wife could take lessons. You should go tutor her. Woman forgot what her mouth is supposed to be used for. I'm telling you right now, Celestine, I swear to God. And I'm not talking about playing the Casio either. I swear to God. Hey, here's what we're doing. We're having a house party. We're going to do an actual show from your house. That's right. We want you to dream up a plan. You tell us, you write us a letter, what guests you'd have, the specifics of what you would bring, and then we'll bring the TV cameras to your house.
So in other words, they plan the entire show, and then we'd come there, and we're a part of it.
Yes!
Ah!
Someone finally understands me!
Eureka!
Yeah. You know, you write us like, hey, Howard, we're going to have hot tub girls. Get it? Hot tub girls, lesbians. You understand, the wilder the better. We'll come to your house. You just write the house party. Care of the Howard Stern Show.
Why are you yelling?
Nine Broadcast Plaza. I feel like Joan Rivers. Nine Broadcast Plaza, Secaucus, New Jersey, 07096. I'm yelling because I'm hyper from the show. I'm doing a radio show 4.5 hours a day. Then I'm writing for the radio show. Then I got the TV show. This isn't even like real television, to tell you the truth.
You look like you're almost ready for the home.
I tell you, look at what I'm doing. This is stupid. Letterman doesn't do this kind of junk. Even Regis, King Regis doesn't wear this kind of crap. All right, now, Celestine, you have just recently not only learned to play this thing, but you can sing and play at the same time.
Yeah.
This is Roy, you're a very lucky man. He's a very remarkable woman.
Well, thank you.
You know I can't even play the piano, and I got two hands? Hard to believe, isn't it? What are you going to do for us to take us out of here?
This song is called You'll Never Walk Alone. And,
Well, that's very true of you. You got Roy wheeling you around. I need somebody wheeling me around. Hey, Roy, marry me and wheel me around. All right, you never walk alone, and you're going to sing at the same time.
Yeah.
All right.
Can you eat spaghetti, play that thing, and sing at the same time? Hey, you're not that talented. Go ahead. And we'll see you next week. Goodbye, everyone. Thanks to Bob Geldof.
Oh, and Stuttering John's still with us.
Stuttering John still works here. We just didn't have time for him, and this will teach him not to ask for so much money. We don't exactly need him. Go ahead.
And you are
costumes provided by Ruby's Costume Company in Richmond Hill, New York. And thanks to the kids, Grace and Christine DiTrolio, Melanie Montemorano, Jacqueline and Tiffany Powers, and T.J. Garrigan.